Hi and welcome to ISBI. Today I'm gonna make two easy to build planter boxes. This build is based on the raised beds I built before I had a YouTube channel. It's a very simple construction, but very stable. I just used tongue and groove boards to build these planter boxes. I started by cutting the boards to the needed length. Then I cut away the tongue and groove from some boards. Next, I use glue and nails to make the legs. Plans for this project are available on my website. Yes, you heard right, I finally made a website. The plans are based on the raised beds, but can be used to make planter boxes in any size and design. In the plans are also some inspirations for planter box designs. The link to my website is in the description and in the upper right corner of the video. When you are on my website, at the top is the main menu. Under Shop are four different subcategories. When you click on Plans English, all the plans in English will appear. If you want to buy a plan, you have just to pay attention which unit system you need, Imperial or Metric. You can see this information in the upper left corner of the item. If you click on Merchandise, you can buy some shirts, hoodies and mugs with my logo on it. And because of my job loss, I made an additional design. I think you know what I mean. At the moment there are not many plans to buy, but I will release more and more plans over time. If you want to be informed when I have published a new plan, you can subscribe to the newsletter on the start page. Next, I attach the sideboards to the legs. The sideboards still have the tongue and groove except the top board. For square planter boxes like these ones, four identical side pieces can be made. In this way, all the sideboards are the same length. This makes the cutting easier and the possibility to make mistakes is decreased. On two of the four side pieces, I attach some strips. The bottom boards will be nailed to these strips later. Next, I assemble the four side pieces to the basic box shapes. Then I cut the parts for the top frame to length and again cut away the tongues and grooves. And here is a little tip for cutting miters on a miter saw if there is a fence with a dust chamfer. By using a small piece of wood with a chamfer which has a certain length, It can be set against the stop block and with the chamfer in the dust channel to prevent that the already cutted mitre pushes the stop block out. Now I cut the mitres to the pieces for the top frame. Then I glue the frame together. After all parts have been painted, I nail in the bottom pieces. Next, I take some measurements to cut the plastic liner to size. Then I put in the plastic liner and attach it with staples. The plastic liner should be in one line with the top edge of the box because the frame will be nailed on top. Then I nail the top frame on. Then I punch some holes in the plastic liner with a screwdriver so the excess water can drip out. The planter boxes are finished and looking great in my opinion. Thank you for watching. If you like my videos, please consider subscribing. Don't forget to click the notification bell and stay tuned for future projects. See ya!